Are you a researcher, student, or applied scientist? Connected papers can help you find similar academic papers that are relevant to your work very fast. Hello, intellects. I am glad to have you back on Insights for You today. This is your number one YouTube channel that helps you achieve your academic goals using modern technology. Would it not be great to have all the articles, papers, and books you need for your research gathered in just one place? Finding the materials you need to write your research papers, thesis, essays, and assignments sometimes could be very tedious. But with connected papers, all your worries are eliminated. When using connected papers, you can understand a brand new academic subject. You can also develop your visual awareness of the current trends, well-known articles, and dynamic movements within your chosen topic. Enter typical search terms, and connected papers will create a graph of similar documents in the area for you to look at. When I used connected papers to find relevant literature for my research, I found papers I didn't see on search engines like Google and Google Scholar. You have no idea how I love connected papers. So, in this video, I will show you how I use connected papers to gather all similar sources relevant to my research. We are going to do this using four simple steps. Let us jump to it now. Step 1, go to connected papers. The link is in the description box below. Step 2, enter your search keywords here in the given search engine. When your first search results come out, make sure you choose the most relevant article to your research. Connected papers will build similar documents in this regard. You can decide to open a given source using Connected Papers, Semantic Scholars, DOI, or Google Scholar. Since I love to have similar and relevant articles for my research, I use the corresponding papers icon to build similar collections. Look at what we have here, lots of similar papers. This graph shows you all similar papers. The size of these circles is determined by how many times the works have been cited. If you want highly cited material, click on the bigger circles in the beautiful graphs. You can get papers that cited many of the documents in the graph from the derivative works icon here. You can also use the prior icons for those most commonly cited by the articles in the graph. Isn't this great? Step 3. Open document and download papers of interest. Click on relevant documents of appeal to see their abstracts, number of citations, and references over here. If you are having a challenge downloading any paper of interest, send me an email, and I will help. It is against YouTube community guidelines to show you how to download any paper you need for free. Step 4, you can cite papers automatically like this. I don't use this part of connected papers because I use my BIB to compile my bibliography quickly. You can see how I use my BIB citation generator in the description box below. For more related papers, use this icon right here. All right, intellects. I hope you found this helpful. In the comments section below, let me know if it is yay or nay for connected papers. See you next time. Stay safe. Bye. See you next time.